might be the spoke shape. I haven't quite figured it out right.
You're growling like an animal. Do you need a perch?
No,
that's all right,
I need it.
You got it. Yeah. Tying up with the black velvet. Do you like your new curved spoke shape? You really do?
It's really useful.
That's cool. We should go and tell him. Mm. Shout out to Dave. Thank you. All about those toes.
Bows and toes. Maybe we could call it bows and toes.
It's a great idea. You're quite the inventor. Bows and toes and dozy totes.
Lotsy tovey.
Kiddly tovey too.
You gotta get your back stronger before you leave.
Hmm.
Do the next bit standing up, mm-hmm. quite high up, because then it can it won't get too wrapped around itself. A little lower down. Thank you. my old man chair. I look like an old man because it curls me round and brings my knees up. And then I'm going to wash the bow.
What consistency are you going for?
Syrup.
Well, what kind of syrup?
Thin.
Yeah. Can cats eat hide?
No.
She seems to think so. Cool. Should I tell you that I can see missing bits from here?
Oh yeah.
And here. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you make Kesha for a second?
I think she's worried about her weight.
Kesha is?
The cat, she's considering weighing herself. Nope, she decided not to.
Why?
You're better off not knowing. Hey, Sasha.
But I'm not sure if this is going to work, because look how thick it's ended up. I'm going to
see if this is okay. So I'll just leave this till tomorrow. I'm not sure what they mix in with the hide when they make it.
I don't really understand how.
I think the red colour happens because, well, the sky is blue because it reflects blue light, bends blue light. So the light coming through at this angle, only the blue bit gets like deflected, so we only see the blue component of the light, and all the rest just goes right through the atmosphere. That's why the sky is blue. But then when it goes on through a lot of atmosphere, all the blue light's been reflected out of the way, it's been deflected, so it gets redder and redder and redder the more of the longer the distance it's been going through the atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
So
that
in the
makes
evening,
sense.
Yeah.
In the evening we're seeing a crossways.
Right.
So we see more illuminated. Let's go. Not as badly as I thought it might be, though.
Yeah.
You having a thunk there?
Mm.
What are you thinking?
I had to make these notes work. But maybe they will work once it's at brace height.
Getting another one.
It's good. Feels fat. That's pretty fat. It's nice to shoot, you know.
Now what's going to happen to this bow?
I
Yeah, Yuri Tuckman made that tool that cuts curbs.
Doesn't cut curbs, it just draws them.
Oh. This isn't right. I think it's going to look like a hill, that bit where your finger is.
Mm-hmm. This is too steep, and this is too deep, and this is wobbly.
But you could do that on purpose and then call it a drumlin bow.
How I'm going to cut edges along it. I'm just thinking. That big. Eyeball, you know. Kind of what happened with the template was I cut it out of the template, so I didn't like it, so I just changed it to how I wanted it.
I can't tell if she's just having a lie down or if she's doing a poo. If she's being a weirdo. Oh no, it's the deer hide. She thinks the log smells nice, the log that the deer hide was on.
Seedled and crisp packets.
Is it because it's vegetarian?
Maybe. It's butter.
Mm-hmm.
nose in the wasp's nest.
This is a lush shot. like it basically dries instantly.
It might not.
And is it more than one layer or just the one?
It does seem like a little bit into it. I'll do me for now.
You need to wear sunglasses just to look at it. It's beautiful. It smells great.
Rawhide.
Rawhide! Rawhide!